अस्सलाम वालेकुम दोस्तों, उम्मीद करता हूँ कि आप लोग खैरियत से होंगे। दोस्तों आज मैं आपको एक वीडियो बताऊंगा कि एक यहूदी जो है वो फलस्तीन लोगों की हिमायत करता है तो क्यों। तो आइए दोस्तों पहले ये वीडियो देखते हैं फिर उससे बात करते हैं।
Welcome to Let the Quran Speak. I'm here with Rabbi Yisrael David Weiss. He supports Palestinians, and I'm going to ask him why that's so. Rabbi, welcome to Let the Quran Speak.
Thank you, and it's an honor, a privilege to be on your program.
No, it's wonderful to talk to you. So tell me, Rabbi, why do you oppose the state of Israel, first of all, and why do you support Palestinians?
Okay, first I pray to the Almighty that He bestow upon me His truth, His wisdom, that I may be worthy of conveying His message and so sanctify His name. It's not my personal opinion. What I'm representing, with God's help, is the opinion of the very religious Jews around the world, mm-hmm. including in Al-Quds in Jerusalem, including, throughout Europe and throughout the world, basically. We as a Jewish people have made a covenant with God 3,000 years ago on Mount Sinai. Moshe Rabbeinu, Moses went up and took the Torah from God, and we made a covenant to uphold the Torah. That is what Judaism is all about, mm-hmm. to uphold this covenant, to be close to the Almighty, to be subservient to the Almighty. This movement, the concept of creating a state sovereignty, and what they want to call a Jewish sovereignty, that concept, is a movement that started around 150 years ago. It is a transformation from subservience to God into nationalism. Hmm. Have a piece of land, to be a nation amongst nations, to be comparable to all the great countries. Now, that in and of itself, even if it would have not affected the Palestinian people, the inhabitants, the indigenous people, in other words, if the land would have been uninhabited, mm-hmm. it would still be forbidden for the Jewish people to have this concept of sovereignty, of a nationalism, because we have a long history. We made the covenant with God 3,000 years ago to uphold the Torah, and we were then commanded to go into the Holy Land and build a temple, which King Solomon built a temple. But we were warned by the Almighty and instructed by the Almighty that we have to be on a very high level of spirituality. If not, then we will be driven from the land. And that came around 2,000 years ago. The Romans and the Greeks, they invaded the Holy Land, and the Jews were driven from the land as a nation. Once that happened, we were put under a decree of exile. And so for 2,000 years, we're under a decree of exile by the Almighty, meaning that we are told by the Almighty that it is His will that we should not be the sovereign nation. We should be loyal citizens in every country we're residing. And we should not attempt to return en masse as a large group of people, or try to recreate even one centimeter of a Jewish sovereignty. Because it is like medicine from God to break our haughtiness. That's what we believe. Mm-hmm. So there is actually we were put under three oaths, and that King Solomon, who built the temple, wrote a book of prophecies called Shir HaShirim, Song of Songs, and he speaks about these three oaths that God put us under. One is that we should not return en masse to the Holy Land once we were dispersed amongst the nations. Secondly, we are not to rebel against any nation. We have to be loyal citizens in every country we reside. A Canadian citizen has to pray for the well-being of the country, even if you're not happy. Or let's say throughout our history, Jews were many times forbidden to buy land, and they were taxed to a much higher degree. Still in all, we have to be loyal citizens and not rebel against that country. Thirdly, we are not to make any attempt to end exile. Why? Because it's because of our sins we are spread out. God is compassionate. And the Almighty, when the time will come, which every Jew yearns for, that the time will eventually come, with the Almighty will make a metaphysical change in the world, and all humanity will recognize one God, then God will return us, and God Himself will rebuild the temple without any human intervention. There will be a spirit, like a miraculous spirit in the world that will stop being atheists and so forth. Everybody will believe in God. It says, all the nations will hold hands and mm-hmm. join to serve God. That will happen. Then we will return and we will become close to God again in His heart.
That how does that come about? Like, how would you know that we're in that state?
We will know that because, like I said, there will be a spirit of holiness, of godliness. There will be a spirit of people returning, the Messiah. See, obviously the Jewish and Muslim people have a distinctly different concept of what the Messiah is, Mashiach. But we believe, but that's really neither here nor there because what will happen, it will happen. And we were never deemed a threat for the Muslim people because of the difference of our approach, because we are clearly, as I've mentioned, we are forbidden to make any attempts to return. Mm-hmm. We just believe and we pray to God constantly that He should bring about this end day and when all humanity will serve Him. So we yearn to return. Mm-hmm. We yearn with all our hearts. We say it in our every day in our prayers that we want. But we haven't. For 2,000 years, we patiently wait and we serve God, upholding the Torah, the covenant, in every land where we are, being loyal citizens and so forth. Zionism was created by mostly non-religious Jews. It was a nationalist movement of people who estranged themselves from God, from the Torah. They were non-religious. I always like to carry around a picture of the first, this was the Declaration of Independence, the first Prime Minister, David Ben-Gurion. And they're making a so-called Jewish state, 1948.
Yes.
And so it's Jewish. Supposedly they're doing us, they're returning to God. They're saying it's the end of exile. And not one of them is covering their heads. Hmm. You know, so you see what the falseness of it, mm-hmm. but still in all, the Zionists, they put on a facade and of Judaism, they incorporated religion in order that the world should say, oh, it's a religious thing, we have to support them, the evangelists, the Christians, and millions support them. Jews who don't know the Torah well, unfortunately, the more non-religious, and they say, oh, and they have this emotional playing, you know, that, oh, it's returning 2,000 years, we're in exile. That's the difference between Judaism and Zionism. Now, so in other words, in short, very concisely, Judaism is subservience to God, Zionism is nationalism, and it's expressly forbidden for us. So around the world, no matter what community, if you go to Argentina, you go to England, Stamford Hills in London, New York, where we're from, The very religious community, and in Jerusalem, the very religious community is in total opposition to the creation of the state. And now I have to add something very important. In other words, for us to have a state, as I said, would be even in an uninhabited land. But being that they created this state in a land that they needed for their purpose, in Palestine, but Palestine was an inhabited land. The majority were Muslims. The second group of people that lived there in numbers were the Christians, and the third were the Jews. Because as individuals, we were allowed to, by God, were permitted to live there, but not as a nation. So in order for them to create their state, they had to expel, at least on the best, the Palestinian people. That is, it flies in the face of what our Torah is about, because in the Torah it says, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal. We have to be mahu rachum, afatate rachum, just as God is compassionate. We have to be compassionate. I mean, and certainly not to steal or kill and expel people. How dare they? And on top of that, we have to remember that in this 2,000 years of exile that we've suffered, so much because we are Jews. The Jews were burnt at the stake. They tried to forcefully convert Jews by the Crusades, by the Inquisition. And when they were expelled from Spain, from Italy, where did the Jews go? The Muslim lands took in the Jews. They embraced us in mm-hmm. every Muslim land. Iran, wherever you would like, Palestine was under the Ottoman Empire. They took us in and we flourished in their lands. There was no human rights groups to protect us, yet we flourished. It wasn't necessary human rights. So now for the Zionists to come along and accuse the Muslims of an ingrained hate to Jews, or the Palestinian people, an ingrained hate, how dare they, how repugnant, how in where we have to show, the Torah requires us to show gratitude for a people, and to go and turn that on its head and say, these people wronged us. All of this is the most criminal part of this, the Arab and Muslim and the Palestinian people would call the Nakba.
Mm-hmm.
We have a picture here even, you can see how we used to live together. and we babysat each other's children. We lived in total peace. That is why the very religious around the world, we stand in total support. We hurt, we cry with the Palestinians. We are humiliated because the Zionists took our religion and they're using it as a tool to occupy, to intimidate, to silence other people, because if you speak up against them, you're called anti-Semitic. So the religious communities stand in opposition.
Mm-hmm. How do you oppose the Zionist movement?
Well, the first thing is we do not accept it. We do not participate with them. We have the very religious communities does not serve in the army, certainly not. They don't go voting. They have nothing to do with the state. We have a rabbinate there. The Zionists made a rabbinate all for this facade, but they masquerade in Jewish, so they made a rabbinate with a chief rabbi, and this is all by us irrelevant. We have a rabbi. We had in the 1920s, the chief rabbi of the religious community that was living there for hundreds of years was Rabbi Zonnenfeld. And he met with the king of Transjordan in 1920s, that's way before the state, to declare our loyalty and that we don't want to stay. He passed on in 1947, 1948, the chief rabbi was Rabbi Dushinsky. The Zionists then turning out to be very successful in having the United Nations, through Britain, to get recognized. So Rabbi Dushinsky, of blessed memory, this is the records of the United Nations. In 1947, a declaration before the United Nations, he said, "We furthermore wish to express our definite opposition to a Jewish state in any part of Palestine." This is the very religious, representing the religious Jewish community, says we don't want a Jewish state. And these people are imposters, the one that are doing it. And the history is, when he passed on, we took the next, you can see hundreds of thousands of people in the streets of Jerusalem taking up our next chief rabbi when he passed on. Mm-hmm. We have hundreds of thousands of Jews living there now under this Eidah Haredi, this God-fearing community that does not recognize the authority of the state of Israel. They demonstrate daily, when they demonstrate and they see children get, we never carry arms, we're not militant, they get beaten, old men get assassinated, rabbis, it's unbelievable. You can go to our site, NKUSA, and see, and the world is silent. They don't even talk about the fact that Jews daily are demonstrating against the occupation, it screams to the skies what is happening, the injustice to the Palestinian people and to the Jewish people who are living there who refuses to accept this authority.
So Rabbi, do you ally yourself with other Jews who are not Orthodox who oppose the state of Israel?
Oh, that is a very good question. Being that there was the Reform Movement like 250 years ago, and our rabbis at that time issued a fatwa, basically,
yeah.
Or 200 of the leading rabbis of Europe, when they said this is a heresy, it's a rebellion against God. You can't reform God's Torah. They don't eat kosher. They don't keep the Ten Commandments. They don't keep the Shabbos, the Sabbath. So they said we're not to be affiliated with them. So we work with the Muslim people. We work with the Palestinian people. And they'll come to the same demonstrations, but we won't have joint activities directly. But if they're there, they do. A lot of them, you know, a lot of people who are Jewish, who are non-religious, they feel it's human rights or because even other Jewish reasons that they'll stand up in opposition. There's many, really, tens and tens of thousands or more who are opposing the occupation. But we are coming from the core issue that the Zionists are claiming the legitimacy. We are telling the world that they're conning the world. It's unacceptable. So we're coming from the religious state. Mm-hmm. And this is a picture of a girl behind bars. Every boy and girl who turns 17 becomes a criminal from the religious community because they refuse to serve in the army, in the IDF, which is mandatory military service. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So these are all very, very critical issues. Why is it so critical for people to understand? Because people, they're very wily, they're very efficient in what they do, the Zionists, and they like to refer to themselves as a Jewish state. They insist to be referred as a Jewish state. Why? Because then they know that if anybody wants to oppose what they're doing, criminal to the Palestinian people, they're taking their homes, they're stealing, they're killing, they're doing so many terrible crimes, But if you say word, oh, you're speaking against a godly religion, so and you're attacked as being anti-Semitic, and now they just made here, they're making a new law, they're trying to pass the IHRA, I think, and that's going to say that if you speak up against Zionism or the state of Israel, it's anti-Semitic. What could be more ludicrous and what could be more unacceptable than such a concept when the very religious communities are being oppressed and insisting we are Jews. My grandparents were killed in Auschwitz. Most of our communities are immigrants from Europe. We died because we were Jews, because we insisted on remaining this religion, our covenant to God. And we did not accept that because we suffered that, therefore, we're going to turn around and occupy another people. We suffered, and now we should go sin against God that we gave our lives for by stealing and killing and doing against God's will. And so we're against the Zionism, and we are being oppressed, the ones of the Jewish people who found a home in Palestine and were living there, these immigrants. And they were living there, they're trying to catch the breath from so much suffering. All of a sudden, they enjoyed being under the authority of the Ottoman Empire. And all of a sudden, they're thrown under the Zionist control and told that if you stand up and oppose this rebellion against God, you are thrown into prison, you are a criminal. How does the world take the authority to dictate in our religion what it's, instead of respecting our scholars, which you have here in Canada, if you have in the United States, we have our community, let's say in New York, it's the largest concentration of religious Jews lived in, right across from Manhattan, Williamsburg, Brooklyn, miles and miles, and there's not one single Israeli flag. The chief rabbi of Palestine, Rabbi Teitelbaum, moved there, and these distinguished communities, thriving, illustrious communities with great scholars and pious people and businessmen, and they all insist that we are a religion to serve God, and God forbid that we should accept the occupation. Mm-hmm. And now if somebody, we decide to speak up against this rebellion against God in the name of my religion, and call out to the world that they're imposters, they're using my religion, that we should be, and people who are standing together with us should be accused of being anti-Semitic, that is unjust, it's unacceptable, and we decry that. And that's what we do we try with God's help. We pray to God that he should bring a speedy and peaceful dismantling of the state. At the same time, we go to the United Nations, we go with Palestinian people to cry their hurt, to speak, go to their demonstrations, to try to educate. We go to universities, to colleges, to conferences, and to tell to the politicians, to have them change their approach and not to support the oppression of the Palestinian people.
Rabbi, thank you for sharing with us today. We really appreciate it. I learned so much, and I'm honored that you came and joined us today.
I'd love to do it again whenever we can expand on all the different issues and our history of how we live together in harmony and in such a beautiful to serve God. And distinctly, you know, we have different religions, but it was never an impediment.
Coexisting.
Mm-hmm. And there's so much to talk about, so much
there
of
is,
the
yes.
facts. So one day we'll continue with God's help.
Inshallah. You say
thank
inshallah
you.
Too, right?
We say in Mi'ertz Hashem or Be'ezah Hashem with God's help.
Mm-hmm.
But I say inshallah. Yes, yes.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us. I appreciate it.
जैसे कि आप लोगों ने आज की वीडियो देखी है तो आप लोगों ने दोस्तों के इस वीडियो में आप लोगों ने इस यहूदी की बातें भी दोस्तों आप लोगों ने सुनी है कि इस जो के अपने मज़हब के बारे में ये क्या कह रहा है दोस्तों इनके मुल्क में कुछ ऐसे तंजीम जो पाए जाते हैं जो कि फ़लस्तीन ममालिक पर हमले करते हैं उनके बच्चे मारते हैं उन पर ज़ुल्म और सितम जो कर रहे हैं दोस्तों जैसे कि इस यहूदी जो जिसने कहा है कि हम जो है अपने तौरात पर जो हम अमल करते हैं उसमें हमने खुदा के साथ जो वादा किया है जो उनके जो दोस्तों इनका जो मज़हब है वो कहते हैं कि इस जितने भी इंसान पर जुल्म और सितम ये तो इंसानियत के ख़िलाफ़ है। दूसरी जो हमारे पास जो तंजीम पाई जाती है दोस्तों उनका ये कहना है अगर हम उनसे यही बात करते हैं कि आप लोग जो है अपनी किताब पर अमल क्यों नहीं करते तो वो कहते हैं कि हम हमारे जो किताब में है ये सही जो रास्ता है वो यही है। दूसरी बात जो दोस्तों सबसे जो अहम बात यही है कि इनका जो कहना है कि पहले जो हम लोग हैं वो फ़लस्तीन के इलाके पर हम रहा पजीर थे फिर वहाँ से इन लोगों को निकाल दिया गया। तो दोस्तों अगर इन लोगों को वहाँ से निकाल भी दिया तो मैं यहाँ पे एक बात करना चाहता हूँ कि दोस्तों यहाँ पे क्या फ़लस्तीन से इनको बच्चों मर्दों को औरतों को मारना क्या इनका जायज़ है या क्या इनकी इंसानियत पर, बल्कि अगर ये जो इनको कोई भी किताब, अगर ये तो इस यहूदी है दूसरा इसराइली है, अरे लोग अपनी किताब पर जो है अमल करते हैं, तो यहाँ पे ऐसे बहुत से जो लोग हैं वो इन लोगों के ख़िलाफ़ ही जो जुल्म व सितम कर रहे हैं, जो कि फ़लस्तीन भाइयों पर जुल्म व सितम कर रहे हैं, उनके बच्चे उनसे छीन रहे हैं, उनकी जो औरतें हैं उनसे छीन रहे हैं, जो बेटी से माँ छीन रहे हैं, बेटे से बाप छीन रहा है, या माओ से जो है उनके बच्चे छीन रहे हैं, जुल्म व सितम जो स्टार्ट हुआ है दोस्तों। तो सबसे पहले जो मैं दोस्तों यही कहना चाहूँगा, अगर इनका जो सबसे बड़ा मकसद है दोस्तों इसराइल का कि इनसे ये फ़लस्तीन कब्ज़ा करना और यहाँ पे अपना जो है टेंपल कायम करना, लेकिन ये इंसानियत के ख़िलाफ़ है। जैसे कि दोस्तों इस यहूदी ने कहा कि हम बहुत से लोगों को ऐसे समझाते हैं जो इन तंजीम से ताल्लुक़ रखते हैं, जो कि मुसलमानों को जो है तबाह बर्बाद करना चाहते हैं, जो मुसलमानों की तंजीम को जो है नुकसान पहुँचाना चाहते हैं, क्योंकि फ़लस्तीन जितने भी मुसलमान वहाँ पर रिहाइश पजीर हैं दोस्तों उनको जो है नुकसान पहुँचाना चाहते हैं। दूसरी तो हम उनसे बात करते हैं और हम जो है कॉन्फ्रेंस पे भी हम बैठ कर इनसे बात करते हैं कि कोई हल निकालो जो कि ये लोग जितने इसराइली हैं जो जुल्म व सितम बंद करे, लेकिन अभी जो है इन लोगों ने कोर्ट में भी एक दरख्वास्त जो है वो दी थी, जो कि उन एजेंटों ने जो कि फ़लस्तीन लोगों पे मुसलमानों पे जो हमले कर रहे हैं उन पे जो जुल्म व सितम कर रहा है वो भी उन लोगों ने पास कर दिया। अगर कोई भी बंदा कोई भी इसराइली के ख़िलाफ़ ऐसे बोलेगा कि ये जो आप फ़लस्तीनी के फ़लस्तीनी लोगों के साथ जुल्म कर रहे हो, वहाँ पर उनको बम्बारी कर रहे हो, जुल्म व सितम कर रहे हो, उनके बच्चे मार रहे हो, उनके औरतें मार रहे हो, ऐसे कोई बम्बारी ऐसे कर रहे हो दोस्तों, वहाँ के उनके सरों पे कोई भी छत नहीं है, तो वो कहते हैं कि इनको भी फिर जो है वो जुर्मदार करार दिया जाता है। जैसे कि दोस्तों इसने कहा कि हम बहुत कोशिश करते हैं कि उन तंजीमों को जो है वो समझाते हैं, हम इस पर जो है ऐसे बहुत से हमने कॉन्फ्रेंस भी किए हैं, असम्बली में भी बैठे हैं, हमको हम उनको सब समझाते हैं लेकिन वो लोग नहीं समझते। दूसरी जो सबसे अहम बात मैं करूँगा दोस्तों कि सबसे जो बड़ा मकसद है इनका इसराइल का जो सबसे बड़ा मकसद है वो है फ़लस्तीन को गज़ा को जो है वो तबाह करना। जैसे कि दोस्तों एक ट्वीट में आया था कि इनके एक बड़े ने ये कहा था कि हम गज़ा से ऐसे हम गज़ा को ऐसे तबाह बर्बाद करने के 50 साल तक लोग याद रखेंगे। तो इनका जो सबसे बड़ा मकसद है दोस्तों इनको जो है कब्ज़ा करना और यहाँ पे अपना जो थर्ड टेंपल है वो कायम करना, शैतानी जो टेंपल है, दर्जाल जो टेंपल है वो कायम करना। जैसे इस यहूदी ने जो बातें की हैं दोस्तों इससे मैं कहता हूँ दोस्तों, अगर एक मज़हब को अगर हम एक साइड पर रखें दोस्तों, अगर एक इंसान पे यहाँ पे जुल्म हो रहा है, अगर दूसरे इंसान वहाँ पर जो है वो देख रहे हैं, तो मैं तो कहता हूँ कि वो इंसान बिल्कुल इंसानियत के काबिल नहीं रहा। जे वहाँ पे कुछ ऐसे लोग जो है रिहा पजीर है जो कि मुसलमानों के जो है बुनियादें हिलाना चाहते हैं, जो कि इस्लाम को नुकसान पहुँचाने में जुटे लोग हुए हैं। और दूसरी जो अहम बात है दोस्तों वो ये है कि जिसका इस यहूदी का जैसे कहे कि हमारी किताबों में लिखा है कि इंसानियत इंसानी हमदर्दी, ये एक बड़ी बहुत बड़ी चीज़ है दोस्तों। अगर इंसान में एक इंसानी हमदर्दी ना हो, अगर कोई इंसान पर जुल्म व सितम हो रहा हो, तो ये कि किसी से माँ से बच्चे छीनना या उन माओ से बच्चे छीनना या बच्चों से माएँ छीनना या उनके वालिद छीनना या उनके सिस्टर या कोई भी ऐसे रिश्तेदार छीनना जिससे कोई नाम और निशान ना रहे, ये कोई इंसानियत वाली चीज़ें नहीं है दोस्तों। ये इनका जो सबसे बड़ा मकसद है वो यही है दोस्तों कि इस्लाम का और फ़लस्तीन को छीनना, उनके ज़मीनों पर छीनना। उनका यही कहना है कि ये ज़मीन पर पहले हम आबाद थे, इन लोगों ने हमसे कब्ज़ा की है, ये है वो है, अब जो है रियासत जो है वो फ़लस्तीन की है, फिर आप लोग फ़लस्तीन और गज़ा से क्यों जो है उनको तबाह बर्बाद कर दिए हैं आप लोगों ने, गज़ा से तो आप लोगों ने कंडर बना दिया है, अभी और भी इन पर पानी बंद कर दिया है, वहाँ पे उनको खाने का कुछ नहीं मिल रहा है, बिजली नहीं है, लाइटिंग नहीं है, कुछ भी नहीं है दोस्तों। बहुत बहुत बड़ा जुल्म व सितम हो रहा है दोस्तों। तो इनके जैसे कि आप लोगों ने इस यहूदी की जो बातें सुनी हैं दोस्तों कि हमारी जो किताबों में लिखा हुआ है दोस्तों कि इन पर जो फ़लस्तीन की जो रियासत है उन पर जो है थोड़े अगर मज़हब कौम से साइड पर रखें थोड़ी सी इंसानियत का तो ख्याल रखना चाहिए, लेकिन तो कुछ तंजीमें हैं दोस्तों जो कि फ़लस्तीन के लोगों को नुकसान पहुँचाते हैं और यही कहते हैं कि हम फ़लस्तीन को किस तरह कब्ज़ा करें, गज़ा को किस तरह कब्ज़ा करें और उनकी ज़मीन हमारे कब्ज़े में आ जाए, वहाँ पर हम यहाँ पर हम तर टेम्पल जो है कायम करें। तो दोस्तों इस यहूदी की जो बातें आप लोगों ने सुनी है, मैं तो कहता हूँ दोस्तों कि इंसान में थोड़ा सा इतना दुख और दर्द होना चाहिए दोस्तों कि फ़लस्तीनों पर क्यों ज़ुल्म व सितम हो रहा है। तो दोस्तों आप लोगों ने ये वीडियो देखी है और उम्मीद करता हूँ कि इस बातों से आप लोग इत्तेफाक करेंगे, बहुत अच्छी वीडियो थी दोस्तों। तो उम्मीद करता हूँ दोस्तों कि ये वीडियो आपको अच्छी लगी होगी, अगर वीडियो अच्छी लगी हो तो अपनी कीमती राय हमारे साथ ज़रूर शेयर करें। वस्सलाम।